Yeah, so I'm going to write down a number for you, Brady. 14972. Now, what's interesting about that number?
It's the subject of a number file video.
Well, it is, but the thing about that number is it's seemingly not interesting at all. Okay, so as of a couple of days ago, I've been reliably informed that this is the smallest number not to appear in any sequence in the online encyclopedia of integer sequences. So this does actually appear in a definition of a sequence as a coefficient in a definition of a sequence, but it doesn't appear in a sequence itself. The first number not to appear at all is the following number. So this is seemingly even more uninteresting. So, okay, can they be uninteresting? Well, let's think about this. And there's actually a mathematical proof, in inverted commas, that says that actually there is no number that is uninteresting, that all numbers are interesting. It's very simple. Let's prove it by contradiction. So let's imagine that n, we're assuming that not all numbers are interesting, okay? So if not all numbers are interesting, then let the number n be the least uninteresting number. Okay, so n is the least uninteresting number. But now, n is the least uninteresting number, so it's interesting. Okay, so that implies that n is interesting. Okay, so you've immediately run into a contradiction. Okay, so all numbers must be interesting. Now, of course, this is slightly dodgy, this proof. It's what we call self-referencing. It's a bit like statements like, oh, can the Almighty create a stone that he can't move? If he's almighty, he can do anything. So he should be able to create a stone that he can't move, but, you know, actually, then he can't move the stone. So there's the problem.
So he's not almighty.
So he's not almighty. So there's something sort of self-referencing in this. So what you really need to do is you need to define what you mean by interesting. So you can imagine doing that. So you say, okay, what makes an interesting number? Well, I'll write down a list of criteria. So maybe a prime number is interesting. A square number is pretty interesting. And you write down a list of things that you think are interesting. And at some point on that list, let's say at the number 28, say, whatever, you write down that it's the least uninteresting number. It's one of the criteria. But that's clearly now, this is ill-defined now. So the problem that you have here is that the criteria aren't well-defined. You need to draw the conclusion about a number before the definition is complete. So it's fundamentally flawed as a logical problem. But let's come back to these numbers.
Okay. These two at the top.
Yeah, let's work on the assumption, of course, this is a number file, right? All numbers are interesting, right? So so these must be interesting, right? So when I found out about these particular numbers not appearing in the OEIS, I thought, right, okay, there's got to be something interesting about them. So indeed, I found something. So I was playing around with them. And what I noticed was the following. So let's calculate the cross sum. Cross sum is when you basically take all the numbers that appear and just add them up. Very simple. So in this case, it's 1 plus 4 plus 9 plus 7 plus 2. Okay, what do you get when you do that? Well, you get 23. Okay, fine. Now look at this one. I'll do it as well. 1 plus 7 plus 0 plus 8 plus 7. And you do that sum, and what do you get? Oh, I get 23 as well. That's pretty cool. So, all right, they both give 23, so that's cool. And what did I notice about 23? Well, 23 is, of course, a prime number. So then I thought, well, there's got to be, I bet you, there's a sequence in that list that has those numbers whose cross sum are prime. And it's there. It's in the list. It's sequence, for anybody who wants to check, A046704. This is the sequence of cross sums who are prime. And so these numbers should really appear in it. But of course, they don't go high enough as this number, but really they should be in there. I guess if they were to do this properly, these numbers would soon drop out. So that's proof, I think, that all numbers are in fact interesting. Anyway, so just thinking about this, it got me thinking a bit more about, is there such a thing as a boring number? Okay, and I found a definition of a boring number online, and there's somebody somewhere has defined a boring number as a number that you can't express in less than 6 English words. So for example, 999, forget the ands, 999 is 4 words, okay, so that's not boring. So I was thinking about it, I think the first one that you come across is probably 1,121. Okay, so this I think you need 6. But then I thought, oh, hang on a minute. What if somebody comes along and says, oh, that's actually 1,121, then I can get it under. But I think 2,121, I think that one is pretty safe. Nobody is calling this 2,121. If they do that, then they annoy me. So this is definitely, this I think is the smallest boring number. But what's happened there? I've just called it the smallest boring number. That's 4 words. So I've sort of fallen foul of my criteria again. Of course, this is all just messing about. You know, there's just not enough of them to cope with the demands that are put on them. It says, well, basically, you look at small numbers and you look at sequences of small numbers, and you can be tricked. You can be tricked into seeing patterns which then don't extrapolate to very large numbers.